Hello everybody, I hope you're doing amazing. Welcome back to a new video, and today I'm here to do a Q&A because a few weeks ago I asked on Instagram if you had any questions about my internship, and I got a few and I'm very happy I'm able to answer them all. First question is, was it hard to get the internship? It was not easy. I had to send quite a few emails to even get one answer saying that they would like to interview me, but most people did not answer at all. I think I sent 10 to 15 emails, something like that. I only sent emails to mostly publishers in Scotland. Mostly, if I got a reply, it was to say that they were not taking any interns because of COVID. And I had already sent an email to the publisher I'm doing my internship with, like to the general one. And somehow I ended up finding the email of the CEO. And I emailed her and she replied saying that they were only offering 6 month long internship and asking me if I was interested and if I would like to interview, and I said yes. And I got my interview. It went well because I'm now doing my internship for Fledgling Press. I will leave all the links in the description. And yeah, it's not the easiest thing, but it's not impossible. I really want to emphasize on this. Although it's not the easiest thing, it's not impossible. There are opportunities out there, you just have to be very persistent, unfortunately. Favorite thing about your internship? I love my weekly meetings. Is that lame to say that? I really like my weekly meetings. I like talking to the other interns and talking to my manager, talking about the books we found, talking about the manuscript we've read, and getting to learn many things. I think, yeah, maybe that's what I love the most, getting to learn about so many different things, because although I'm an editorial intern, I also do things for production or for marketing and things like that. Yeah, the variety, getting to learn about so many things. I think that's also something you get a lot more if you do an internship with an independent publisher. You get to do a little bit of everything and you get to learn way more than if you work with, I don't know, one of the big five, something like that. So yeah, I'm loving the variety. What is your typical day like? So I don't have a typical day, I would say, because, well, first of all, I'm working at home, and honestly it's kind of different every single day. During the first few weeks, I mostly read submissions and said if we accept it or not, and then I read the manuscripts I accepted. But now I have different tasks. I'm in charge of the Instagram account, so I take pictures and I post 3 times a week about our backlist. And one of the very recent things I had to do was typesetting a book, so it meant I had to put it through InDesign and just get it ready for printing, which was so exciting. I love doing this. And yeah, I do a lot. At the moment, I'm also proofreading the manuscript. It's behind me in the envelope. So I have a manuscript to proofread. It's different every single day, but yeah, as I said, I love it. I love the variety. It's very exciting to get to work on so many things and get to learn about many aspects of publishing. What studies have you done in France to get here? So I already did a few videos about my bachelor's degree, but basically I did a bachelor's degree in Anglo-Saxon civilizations, literatures and languages. So if you're in France, it's LLCR Anglais. So basically I had to study American civilization, British civilization, American literature, British literature. I also had Scottish civilization, Irish civilization, Irish cultural history. I think I had Scottish cultural history as well. I had phonetics, I had translation, I had phonology. Yeah, all the good stuff. Do you get proofs? Technically, a manuscript is a proof. So considering that I'm proofreading a manuscript, I would say yes. The book I have behind me is being released in June of this year, so you bet your ass I'm counting for my Goodreads challenge. So, in a way, I am. Manuscript, the kind of proofs, like if we're going to publish them during the year, it counts. What are your main tasks? How did you get that position? So, I think I kind of already answered my main task, but I can recap. So, at the very beginning, my job was to read 15 submissions a week and accept them or reject them. And if I accepted them, I had to request the manuscript, read the manuscript, and write it in a book report. I still have to read some manuscripts that I haven't gotten to yet. And I will have to write book reports on them saying if I think or not that it's a good idea to go further with them. So I do a little analysis of the book. I see if it has a market or not, if it goes with our backlist. And I also now take care of the Instagram account, so I have to take pictures of our books, I have to post about them, so I have to write a little caption, engage with book bloggers, and it's a lot of fun. I'm loving doing the Instagram account. The authors are really fun, like they come in under the post and it's really funny. So yeah, I do this, and as I said, I had to do the typesetting for our first release of the year, and it was a lot of fun. I really liked doing this on InDesign. I know InDesign can be a bit scary at first, but the thing with InDesign is that the more you practice, the easier it gets. Typesetting is basically getting a book to be ready to be printed. It's tedious work, but so satisfying. Also, I got to experiment a little bit, see if this or that would fit the book best. Like at some point during one of our manuscripts, we have a mixed media and I had to create a little, I don't know if it's interesting for you, but I had to create a little paragraph style and then apply it everywhere, and I had to see if it worked or not. And yeah, I just really like doing this. And yeah, I'm also proofreading a manuscript, so yeah, these are my main tasks. What are the projects slash assignments that you love doing? Can I repeat myself once again? I loved doing the typeset. I loved doing it. It's just so satisfying to know that you are the person getting the book ready to be printed. Like when I will have the book in my hands, I'll be like, this is my work. I did this. What I really liked with this is that I was able to send my ideas to my manager and she proved them, so I was able to get my little personal touch in the book, and that's just so satisfying. And as I said, I also love taking care of the Instagram account. I love interacting with the authors, I love interacting with the bloggers. This college community is pretty amazing, I have to admit. Do you think your internship in Scotland gives you advantages in comparison to doing it in France? Considering that I don't want to work in France, yes. It just depends on where you want to work, and I don't see myself working for a publishing company in France or a company that publishes books in French. So these are all the questions I got. I had to put some together because some of them were the same or very similar. But yes, if I didn't answer your question, please let me know in the comments and I will answer there. But yes, that's going to be it for this video. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. That would make me very happy. And if you're not subscribed yet, maybe you can. Of course, only if you want. And if you want to be notified for whenever I post a new video, click on the little bell. But I hope you will have an amazing rest of your day. Please remember that you're loved, and I will see you in another video. Bye.